Hi friends, so welcome you all to the second video with respect to SEBI current affairs of the month of January 2018. So first one is SEBI in talks with National Payment Corporation of India or NPCI to reduce the listing time. So the time which is involved in listing of the securities on the stock exchange, so SEBI is trying to reduce this particular time. And for this purpose, it is discussing with NPCI to develop an alternate payment mechanism through which the money can be transferred from the prospective shareholders to the company in an effective manner and at a faster pace, so that this entire process can be completed in a swift manner. The investors can get shares and the company can get money. So if this is an efficient payment mechanism which is developed, this has the potential to reduce the time and cost associated with the public issue, and this is going to reduce the market risk for shareholders by allowing them unblocking of capital. So this is how this thing works. If this alternate efficient mechanism which is to be developed by NPCI it works out, it can work wonders for both the shareholders and the company. So SEBI is doing various reforms with regard to IPO listing, and SEBI has already reduced the IPO listing time from 7 days in the past to 6 days. So this is one of the reforms, and SEBI is now planning to reduce further these 6 days to around 3 days. Now these National Payment Corporation of India, this is an important organization of India. This is an umbrella organization for retail payment and settlement systems in India. Next is SEBI to accept only online filing of records from 1st of April. So online filing of records related to offer documents, schemes of arrangement, takeover and buybacks, they need to be submitted only online to SEBI from 1st of April. So if different sets of documents they are to be submitted to SEBI, the only method left, the only option left is to submit them online from 1st of April. Now in order to facilitate the ease of operations, SEBI has introduced this particular online system, and now all the works with regard to filings related to public issues, rights issues, institutional placement program, etc., they all have to be done online. SEBI has also advised the registered merchant bankers and recognized stock exchange that they should activate their online accounts, because now all the activities are to be done online. So next is SEBI may tighten shareholding net worth norms for exchanges. So SEBI is thinking of tightening the net worth norms, bring in new shareholding rules and ease directorship conditions for stock exchanges, depositories and clearing corporations. So for these entities, stock exchange, depositories and clearing corporations, which are important sets of entities associated with the securities market, SEBI is thinking to bring some changes in the norms. Now with regard to the net worth requirement, now I believe you are aware about this concept of net worth. Net worth means the excess of assets over liabilities. So presently, the stock exchanges are required to have a net worth of at least 100 crores and the clearing corporations at least rupees 300 crores. So SEBI is thinking to tighten it, that is increasing this requirement. Further, SEBI is planning to introduce a formula-based net worth criteria on the basis of size of the business for potential demand. So if the size of business is higher, then that particular exchange and the clearing corporation must have a higher net worth. So SEBI is thinking of coming out with this formula. Now earlier, 5-member panel headed by R. Gandhi, who is former deputy governor of RBI, this panel was constituted and it is considering these proposals actively. Now another important term associated with these is appointment of public interest directors. Now public interest directors, they are appointed by SEBI as the public representatives. So they are having a duty towards the SEBI, the market and the shareholders. So they are those directors who are keeping the interest of the different stakeholders at check. So the new rules which they are being planned to be issued, they aim at aligning the important appointment terms for public interest directors which are appointed on the boards of stock exchange and other market infrastructure institutions like clearing corporations with the Companies Act. So at present there are some different sets of terms associated with the public interest directors, but now with these new norms which the SEBI is planning, these will be aligned with the provisions of Companies Act. So as of now, public interest directors, they are nominated for a 3-year term and they may be re-nominated only after a cooling period of 1 year. And now the committee is allowing a term of 5 years for such directors, keeping the maximum instance of appointment at 2 terms. So they can only be appointed for 2 terms of 5 years. After that, there has to be a cooling period. So these are some changes which are being brought in the different sets of requirements with regard to different market infrastructure institutions. Next, SEBI permits voluntary exit of 2 exchanges. So these are the 2 exchanges, India Paper and Spice Trade Association and Rajkot Commodity Exchange. So these are the 2 exchanges. So SEBI has allowed them to stop their operations as commodity derivative exchanges after they voluntarily decided to exit. Now both these entities, they have been allowed to cease after they complied with the requirements of exit policy. So this is very important. So there is an exit policy which has to be complied if you want to exit from the commodity derivative exchange. So after they complied with these requirements, then only they were permitted to leave. Now Kochi based IPSTA, that is Indian Paper and Spice Trade Association, had recognition as a commodity derivative exchange in respect of paper, while the Rajkot Commodity Exchange, it was having commodity license for castor seed contracts. Now there was no trading on these exchanges on this Indian Paper since April 2016 and on the Rajkot one since December 2016. So no trading was happening and now they decided to voluntarily exit and SEBI has permitted this. Next is SEBI eases scheme of arrangement rules for listed companies. So SEBI has relaxed the disclosure, the promoters lock-in and the listing related compliance requirements for the listed firms undertaking the schemes of arrangement. So schemes of arrangement means the schemes like mergers, demergers involving subsidiaries and divisions. So if you are doing some restructuring of your business, then the SEBI has allowed you certain concessions and SEBI has eased certain norms for you. For example, the listed companies are no longer to require submit certain documents to the stock exchange following the sanction of the National Company Law Tribunal or the High Court. So if the company is doing such kinds of mergers or restructuring, there are some approvals which are to be taken, and earlier the documents of approval, they were also required to be submitted to the stock exchange. Now this provision has been done away. So this decision has been taken by SEBI after it received different representations suggesting improvements to the existing regulatory framework. So if we learn about this scheme of arrangement, now this scheme of arrangement or a scheme of reconstruction is a court approved arrangement. Now this is an arrangement which is happening between the company and its shareholders or the creditors. So what may happen? There may be a case when the company was set up and the company now is not at a good position. So company's assets, they are not sufficient to pay off the liabilities and now the company is at the juncture of being wound up. Now in order to save that particular company, the company and its shareholders and the creditors, they will come together and decide to revive the company, and this will be known as a scheme of arrangement. So the shareholders and the creditors, they may agree to reduce their claims, they may agree to push in more money, they may agree to reschedule debt. So these kinds of arrangements, they may be taking place in this scenario, and it may affect mergers and amalgamations and may alter shareholder or creditor rights. So these schemes of arrangement, they may be affecting the mergers, they may be affecting the amalgamations, they may be altering the shareholder or creditor rights. So this is not something which is too different for you guys. So broadly we have to remember that these arrangements, they are done between a company and its shareholders or creditors in specified cases. Next is SEBI plans to hire a full-time chief vigilance officer. So SEBI is planning to appoint a full-time chief vigilance officer, and this is to be done primarily to keep a check on its officials and their dealings. So SEBI wants to keep an eye on its officials in order to make sure that they do not indulge in any sets of activities which are not commensurate with the functioning of SEBI. And for this purpose, SEBI is considering full-time chief vigilance officer. So this full-time officer will be responsible for detecting and punishing malpractices within the SEBI organization. Now presently SEBI, though is a very small organization with a strength of only around 800 employees, it is having a part-time CVO since its inception. So now SEBI is thinking to convert this post into full-time chief vigilance officer. Next is SEBI eases proposed electronic book platform rules. So SEBI has eased the proposed rules related to electronic book platform. Now this electronic book building platform means a bidding mechanism for bond sales on a private placement basis on stock exchange. So this electronic bidding platform, electronic book building, this platform is to be used for the companies who are aiming to raise funds through bonds on a private placement basis. So this private placement means that you are issuing these bonds only to a set of particular private set of investors and not the public at large. Now for any kind of issue of the company, the price of the issue has to be determined, and this book building is a procedure, is a way to determine the price of the issue. So this electronic book building helps us to do this whole process in an electronic manner. So now SEBI has, what it has done, it has eased the rules related to electronic book building platform, because the earlier rules, they were way too restrictive. They were having different sets of conditions which are not commensurate with promoting ease of doing business in the country. So if you try to understand the meaning of book building, now during the IPO, that is initial public offer, or the FPO, that is follow-on public offer. IPO means when the company first time issues its shares to the public, and FPO means subsequent issue of shares to the public. Now during these IPO and FPO, the company is offering its shares to the public, and they can either be issued at a fixed price or on a price range. Now when the company is issuing the shares at a particular price range, the company just provides the price range, and the actual price is discovered using the bids which are received from the investors. The method which is involved is the book building method. Next is SEBI may soon take measures to limit retail participation in F&O market. So SEBI is thinking to take measures to reduce the retail participation in the derivatives segment. Now we've already seen how the derivative segment is very risky, and you can get a high amount of exposure just by paying the margin money. So that is why it is being felt that retail investors who are having some hard earned money with them, who wants to invest this money, they should not be exposing themselves to the high risks associated with the derivatives market or the futures and options market. That is why the finance minister feels that SEBI should implement measures that boost the growth of cash equity market rather than derivative market. In 2017, F&O turnover was 18.21 times that of cash market turnover, compared to 9.32 times in 2011 and 3 times in 2009. So you can see how the turnover of this future and options segment, the derivative segment, is increasing tremendously, and the government, the SEBI, they are worried about the interest of retail investors. So if you talk about the risks in F&O market, now futures and options market, we have seen that it is a hedging tool. We have seen how the derivatives can be used to hedge your position. For example, if you have to buy this buy wheat at a future date for your flour factory, for your biscuit factory, then you can enter a contract right now for deciding the price of that particular purchase. So then you are doing hedging. You are simply avoiding your risk. But some people, they enter into these derivative contracts just to make money. They're not having any biscuit factory. They just want to make money, and that's why they enter into these sets of contracts. So entering into the derivatives contract is very easy, and you just need to pay 10 to 20% initial margin. You need not pay the entire money which you would have paid when you have acquired the shares. You just need to pay 10 to 20%. So just by paying rupees 20,000, you can get exposure of up to rupees 2 lakhs. So if there is any loss, then your loss is also going to be very high. So if these 2 lakh worth of securities, it becomes rupees 1,50,000, your loss is rupees 50,000, and the margin which you deposited was just rupees 20,000. So this is exposing you to a huge amount of risk, and that is why it is being felt that the retail investors should be shielded from such kinds of risk. Next is SEBI to weigh minimum market cap for companies to stay listed. So SEBI is thinking to impose a limit on the minimum market capitalization for the companies who wish to remain listed. So market capitalization means the share price multiply the total outstanding shares of the company. So this would give us market capitalization. So this market capitalization will be low if either your share price is low or your total outstanding shares, they are low. And this is usually the case with penny stocks. So SEBI is thinking to weed out the penny stocks, and that is why SEBI is considering a proposal to have a free float market cap of rupees 10 crore for companies to remain listed. At present, there is no such criteria. However, the exchanges such as BSE and NSE, they stipulate a minimum market cap of rupees 25 crore at the time of listing. So SEBI is no criteria, but exchanges, they may have this criteria. But now SEBI is also thinking to come up with this criteria. So let's understand the meaning of this free float market cap. Now let's understand through this example. Now suppose the total number of shares in a company is 100 and the price of each share is rupees 10. So the total share price would become rupees 10,000. So in this particular case, the entire market capitalization of the company is rupees 10,000. Now if out of these shares, 10 shares they are owned by the board of directors of the company and 90 shares they are owned by the public. So these 10 shares which are owned by the internal persons, the board of directors, they are not to be computed while calculating the free float market cap. Because this is not being made available for free trade in the market, this is just sitting, just lying in the pockets of the board of directors. The actual amount of shares which are there for trading in the market are just 90 shares. So that's why the free floating market cap is going to be 90 into 100, 90 into 10, that is 900. So the total market capitalization is rupees 900. So this is the concept of free float market capitalization. Next is SEBI extends deadline for stock brokers to set up records of client orders. So SEBI has extended this deadline for the stock brokers to comply with the requirement, and this requirement is to keep evidence of every instruction which is given by the client for equity and equity derivative trade. So any instruction which is given by the client to these brokers, they have to be properly recorded by the brokers in order to make sure that the brokers, they are acting in the interest of the investors or the stock or the persons who have bought the stocks. So SEBI has directed all brokerages to compulsorily record every phone call of their client or to keep evidence of all the trade related instructions in writing. So there should be a proper instruction whenever any stockbroker has to take any action on behalf of the client. And this is to be done to prevent any risk arising from any unauthorized trading. So there may be a case in which the broker, without the permission of the client on whose behalf he is holding the shares, he may sell those shares. So this is unauthorized trading and SEBI is thinking to curb this one. So that's why SEBI has brought these rules in which it is being made mandatory from the stock brokers to keep proper evidence of every instruction received from the client. Next is SEBI is planning a riskometer for stock market investment. So SEBI is thinking of introducing this early warning system. This would caution people about the risk of investing in stocks of overvalued companies, unsustainable business models, and the ones that may go bankrupt. So SEBI is planning a riskometer for such set of stock market investments so that the common people, they are made aware of the risk associated with investing in these sets of securities. Now the proposed system would rate a stock on a numerical scale or a color-coded system. So this is going to easily help the investors to identify the risk associated with a particular stock before investing his money. So this kind of riskometer can be in the huge interest of the investors. Next is SEBI should not discriminate between large and small credit rating agencies. So the domestic and the newer credit rating agencies, they have said that certain practices in the industry, they need to be addressed, as SEBI recently amended the regulations related to credit rating agencies in the country. So SEBI came out with these new regulations which have some strict conditions, like it is now mandatory for promoters to maintain a minimum holding of 26% for at least 3 years. Credit rating agencies holding more than 10% of the voting rights, they cannot hold a stake of 10% or more in another credit rating agency. This restriction does not apply to holdings in CRAs by the pension funds, institutional investors, insurance schemes, and the mutual investments. Now, the younger credit rating agencies, they feel that these requirements, complying with these requirements, they are very difficult, and they should not consider that domestic and the newer credit rating agencies, they are at par with the global credit rating agencies. They should be pushing the smaller ones, pushing the domestic and the newer credit rating agencies by giving them some concessions and not imposing all the new regulations at one go on all the new or domestic credit rating agencies. Now let's take a look at some of the questions which can be framed out of this topic. Which of the following is correct with regard to public interest directors? They are appointed by SEBI. They have a duty of care to SEBI, the market and the shareholders. Both are correct. So here the answer is going to be option number C, because both these statements, they are correct. Next is, which of the following is incorrect regarding electronic book building platform? Options are, it was launched in July 2018. The bidding platform for the companies, it is a bidding platform for a companies aiming to raise funds through bonds on a private placement basis. Both of the above or none of the above. So this, we have also seen that this platform was launched in 2016 and not 2018. So here first one is going to be incorrect. So the answer is going to be option number A. Next is, market capitalization of a company can be calculated by. So this is very simple. We have seen that if you multiply the share price by the outstanding shares, you can calculate the market cap. So here the answer is going to be option number A. Next is, during the IPO or FPO, company opting book building method offers the share to the public. Options are, at a fixed price through a range of prices used for effective price discovery, either or none. So this we have also seen, that book building method, in this method there is a price range, and through this price range the actual price is discovered. So answer will be option number B here. So friends, these are the answers. So friends, this was all about our discussion on the SEBI current affairs for the month of January 2018. Thank you.